Welcome to the Yuma Center Benefit, streaming from Washington, D.C. My name is Sharon Heffron. I am the Executive Director here at Yuma Center. My co-host is Maura Delaney, our Advancement Director. Welcome, Maura.
Thank you. It is a joy to be welcoming all of you from across the country. Since last year, we started serving women from 44 states and 17 countries. Hence, this evening's theme, D.C. Roots, Global Reach. Sharon, let's hear more about Yuma Center.
At Yuma Center, we encourage and enable women to be their best selves, to keep growing, whether they're 9 or 99. We serve a broad audience through our wide scope of professional, personal, and spiritual programming. Women and girls can take advantage of one or all three types of our program offerings. They, in turn, impact generations.
We are often asked, what makes the Yuma Impact so unique?
What I have heard participants say is that they appreciate, one, our positive outlook on work and professionalism in everything we do. Two, we challenge women and girls to use their talents to serve their families, society, and God in and through the work that they do, from the hill to the home and everywhere in between. Three, Yuma develops the whole woman through the integration of their minds, heart, and soul. We support women and girls of all faiths and professional backgrounds. It's our breadth and depth. That's what makes Yuma Center so unique.
Amazing. As our programs expanded far and wide, our donor base grew 65% between 2019 and 2020. We currently are in the final year of a three-year, $2 million campaign. The purpose of this campaign is to continue our growth and impact and establish a solid foundation as a leader in women's development for generations to come. Each year, at our benefit, Yuma honors a woman who has embodied our bold mission. This year, we are delighted to honor Elizabeth Heil Bergin. More on that later. In the meantime, for those of you who have already contributed, particularly to our benefit sponsors, we thank you for your friendship and the sacrifices you have made for Yuma Center. For those of you who are not attending in person, there are still ways for you to jump in and support our work at Yuma. First, check out our raffle baskets for the Four Faces of Yuma. On our website, you will also find Fund the Yuma Impact. Raffle and Fund the Yuma Impact can be found at yumadc.org/benefit. Lastly, please share this video and help us promote our programs. Sharon, what if we now hear from some of the women who benefit from our Yuma programs?
Maura, I think that is an excellent idea.
My name is Allison Shepardak, and I have participated in Yuma's Next Five program, in their retreats, in their professional soirees. I've been a guest speaker for the Yuma Prep Series, and I also have participated in the monthly recollections.
My name is Priya Narona Pinto. I live in Alexandria, Virginia. I live with my husband and my four children. I have two daughters and two sons, and I am a lawyer in downtown DC.
Next Five is a phenomenal program that Yuma has, which is all about integration. Integration being a big buzzword where it teaches us to integrate the five different areas of our life and does this through monthly seminars where we get together and we hear from a guest speaker, and then we have a discussion component in smaller groups afterwards. And the coaching, the mentoring, the discussion, the fellowship has been remarkable.
One of the great things about Next Five is that it's a group of women who have come from all different experiences and perspectives. We come from all over the country. I'm probably on the older end of the spectrum, but I've got young kids. There are women who are younger, who have older kids. There are women who are single, women who are married with no kids. It's just a great group of different women, different professions, different perspectives. And we share all of the common challenges that we face being women in the workforce and trying to live full lives and incorporate all the various different aspects of our lives into one joyful path forward.
Another great program is the Monthly Moms Club. And this was started a few years ago by Elizabeth Bergin. And it's really, again, reached a lot of moms who maybe feel a little lost or lonely as they're starting their journey as a mother.
My name is Joanna Marino. I have been married for almost 25 years, and I'm the proud mom of 9 kids.
I think it's the friendships that are really beneficial for especially the new moms who maybe feel a little lonely and lost when you're home a little bit more with your baby, or if you're out working and trying to like juggle a professional life. This club can really help you connect with different people who are in the exact same stage as you. And I think it's just a great, great program here at Yuma.
I think one of the most difficult jobs that we have is to be moms. Nobody prepares us to be one. Our babies, they don't come with a manual, but we can come here to Yuma and we can get good advice. We can share with other moms the trials and the blessings that come with being a mother, and also to listen to good speakers.
There is a well-known proverb that says, when you educate a man, you educate an individual. But when you educate a woman, you educate a generation. And this is so true. And here at Yuma, this is a very special place where women are cared for. So we also can care for others, beginning with our families, friends, co-workers, and people around us.
Hey, hi, I'm Dee Dee Maloney. I'm from Kensington, Maryland. And I have been coming to Yuma even before Yuma was here. I was here at the groundbreaking many years ago. It was a beautiful day. Brought my whole family because I was all about the programs that had been in existence and were going to flourish with the new building.
Hi, I'm Regina Rowan. I'm homeschooled. I'm a senior in high school. And I do the recollections at Yuma that are once a month. I've been doing Yuma prep since freshman year. And I also do the retreats, which are yearly. So I started Yuma prep in freshman year of high school, and I didn't know I was doing it. My mom told me I was. And I wasn't super into it as a freshman. I kind of went in with a poor attitude. But over the years, I really grew with it. And I think Yuma helped me mature and grow and learn about professionalism and virtue. And by senior year, I've come to love it, and I love coming here, and I come here on my own time with my own car, and my mom doesn't have to take me here anymore because I want to be here. So I've become a big fan of Yuma.
I'm Alice Holian, and this is
Holian. I'm Luke Holian.
And we've been a longtime supporter of Yuma since they've opened their doors. I think that Yuma itself is such a incredible concept for supporting women and young women and girls at so many different stages in development through their lives, careers, and life changes. I myself started off when I had no children and I was working, and so it was a great resource for work and life balance, as well as building skills on how to manage stress and work challenges and even just life challenges. So it's an important resource, I think, for the DC area and now globally too.
Yuma has had an extraordinary impact on my life. It has made me a more confident and grounded woman. I have grown spiritually, professionally, and I also have so many friends, and I love being able to see role models at all stages of life who are really tapping into their feminine genius and learning more about their faith and themselves and how they can give in their family life, their personal life, and their professional life as well.
Yeah, I just feel like Yuma and the programs here really help me feel like I can conquer the world, whether it's one load of laundry at a time or one board meeting at a time.
Yuma has had a great impact in my life. I couldn't imagine where my life would be right now without it. And when I needed help with motherhood topics, Yuma was there. When I needed help with my professional life, it was there.
Yuma is life-giving. It is a place where you can build friendships, develop relationships that'll last you your whole life, and trickle down through the generations of your family.
As I finish this year with Yuma Prep, I think about how grateful I am and the journey I've been through my 4 years of high school with Yuma, starting as a freshman and ending as a senior. And I've come to really love this place and their program and what they do for young women, and I hope that they reach many more.
You know, why do I support Yuma? you know, my oldest child is a daughter, is my daughter. And there's no other place I would want her to be than at Yuma.
As you said earlier, Maura, we are delighted to honor Elizabeth Bergin. We are honoring Elizabeth Heil Bergin this year for her years of dedication to our efforts to advance Yuma's mission. Elizabeth has shown a selfless example of what it means to dedicate her wisdom, talents, and experience to serving women and families in their work and life. Among the many initiatives at Yuma, Elizabeth's support has been a catalyst for programs for mothers, women in the arts, and Next Five, all while being an active member of the board of directors and generous benefactor along with her husband, William.
Thank you, Sharon. Now, let's hear from a few people who have worked with our honoree and know her personally.
Elizabeth, thank you so much for your friendship, your leadership, and for all that you do for Yuma and for the women in our community and for mothers. Congratulations. I can't think of a better person to honor tonight.
Elizabeth, 16 years ago, you and I met in New York City. You had just returned from 6 years in Rome. We became fast friends. Then you married and moved to Washington, D.C. And then a few years later, I moved to Washington, D.C., and you and I got involved in Yuma Center. I was privileged to launch with you the Mothers Club, the Yuma Mothers Club, which is a great success and going strong. But I must confess, my crowning joy is being a key player in introducing you to your wonderful husband, Bill. Elizabeth, congratulations, and thank you so much for your generous service to Yuma, and thank you for being my friend.
And with Elizabeth, she's joyful. She brings joy wherever she is. I know when Alice has been talking or been with Elizabeth because that rubs off with Alice. So she's always in a good mood when she comes away with being with Elizabeth. And she's courageous during this time of the pandemic, you know, to take on all these different programs and to keep them going. It's very courageous. And then to still be there for her friends. And I know, you know, the pandemic's been lonely for a lot of people. And it's really been, you know, when I hear that Elizabeth's coming over, I'm like, great, Alice is going to be in a great mood today.
Yes, I would want to say to Elizabeth, thank you for your inspiration in being the real deal, and we love you.
Elizabeth, congratulations. I'm so happy. When I first found out you were going to be honored this year, I was just, of course, so happy for you, but I thought to myself, it's perfect. She's just so wonderful. I don't know if you remember the first time we met, but I met you, had a short conversation, and thought, I want to be her friend. She's so great. And just felt very blessed that we've had so many moments together and our girls getting to hang out a little bit and talk about their futures and everything, just being a mom. And you have inspired me probably in more ways than you know. And I just want to say congratulations.
We welcome you to join us in advancing our mission. You will find ways to support this benefit at yumadc.org/benefit. This is our largest fundraiser of the year, and all money raised is contributed to Campaign for Yuma. Thank you again to our many sponsors for your continued support and encouragement. We are deeply grateful.
Thousands of women are looking for our fresh perspective on integrating work with the rest of their daily life. We encourage you to join us in this journey to inspire the women in your life. We are impacting generations. Thank you again for joining us, and
congratulations, Elizabeth.